event are members of the South Dakota High School Activities Association, which have adopted the rules under which the games are conducted. A strong commitment to excellence, fair play, and sportsmanship are all vital to this activity's success. We would first like to introduce the starting lineup for the visiting Sioux Falls Washington Warriors. A junior forward number 2, Philemon Alamasi. A sophomore midfielder number 4, Alex Stonehall. A senior midfielder number 6, Alec Trey. Junior goalkeeper number 7, Nick Gregg. A senior forward number 9, Tamer Sidlaw. A senior midfielder number 10, Walter Gatica. A senior midfielder number 11, Austin Miller. A senior defender number 12, Alex Durr. A junior defender number 13, Kyle LeBron. A junior defender, number 15, Akila Dita. And a sophomore defender, number 21, Ben Treblecup. The Warriors are coached by Dave Denver, assisted by Lloyd Newman, Gabe Steinberg, and Daniel Oyeha. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the starting lineup for your Rapid City Stevens Raiders. Goalkeeper number 0, Nicholas Schmidt. A junior forward number 2, Blake Bent. A junior midfielder number 3, Christian Cropper. A junior midfielder number 8, Jacob Nunez. A junior defender number 10, Matthew Brambley. A sophomore midfielder, number 11, Amber Mom. A junior forward, number 12, Jacob Hall. A senior defender, number 13, Tyler Poliski. A junior forward, number 18, Jace Hapes. A sophomore defender, number 20, Devin Hansen. And the senior defender, number 22, Brandon Cruz. The Raiders are coached by Jacob Meyer, assisted by Jeremy Fiorello and Aaron Moss. The Stevens trainer is Paul Richter. Your officials for tonight's game are center referee Tony Harrison and assistant referees Monty Eisenbrod and Aaron Gore. These officials are certified by the South Dakota High School Activities Association. Ladies and gentlemen, we have an opportunity to be singing of the national anthem prior to the girls' varsity game, so we're going to get up here.
See ya. There you go. Be part of the action. Well, folks, welcome to the last game tonight between the Washington Warriors and the Rapid City Stevens Raiders. We have next door the Rapid City Central Cobblers and Sioux Falls Lincoln Patriots. We'll try to keep you up to speed on those scores. You heard them introduce the teams. center referee Tony Harrison over there talking to Stevens coach Jacob Meyer. Just in. Quite a surprise. Rapid City Central varsity girls dispatching defending state champ Lincoln 7-2. Sounds like a tremendous effort over there. Forty minutes. Probably cool enough now. They won't be going for a water break tonight in the middle of the half. And off we go. Thank you. I'll survive many prior ones. Thank you. Both sides kind of feeling the other ones out right now. Seeing how they're going to respond to the different ideas they're going to put out here. We want to remind all you folks who are watching from Sioux Falls that there will be a benefit tomorrow starting at 2 o'clock at the Gateway Lounge. Benefit for Coach Danielle O'Han. So get on down there at 2 o'clock. Help raise some money for Danielle's fight against cancer. Danielle O'Han, probably the most influential person in South Dakota soccer. Like Ben after that for the Raiders up top. And that's going to run out for a goal kick. Washington keeper Nick Gregg will put the ball in play here. And they have just kicked off in the Rapid City Central Sioux Falls Lincoln game. Ball drops in. Nice save there. Boy, oh boy. Washington had a man. Tanner Zitlow. He was on it. Brandon Cruz right there. And the keeper. Long ball up. It's a race to the end. Flicked back in. It's kept in. And Nick Gregg pulls that in for the Warriors. Looking for Zitlow up top. Austin Miller. And that shot by Blake Bent goes left, but you're seeing the kind of speed that guy has. When he has a step on you, it's going to be all over with the slow singing. At the very least, he'll get a shot off like he did there. Stone off. They bring it back around. Gilda. Swing it on across. They're going into the corner. Nice cut back. How's it going? Austin Miller tries to put one through, and that's blocked. Miller tries going through. That Stevens defense just collapses there. Gattica puts one in with his left. That's bang back out of there. Hmm. Real nice ball movement here by Washington in possession. You know, the final third. And a shot that sails over. Miller sends it into the box on the far side. That's headed out by Stevens. Well, Washington gets it back. Nunez. Nunez has a toe poke in, and that's easily handled by Nick Gregg. Foul, and that'll be no connection there for the Raiders. Jace Hayes trying to go forward there for Stevens. Right winger. A junior. We're just in University of South Dakota. Coyotes women's soccer defeated by Creighton 1-0. All right, free kick just outside the 18. And that attempt just misses. Miller with the ball. He cuts back, draws a lot of attention from the white shirts. Alec Cray having a try forward there. Washington tonight doing a real good job moving the ball out of pressure. Turned out to be a real nice night for soccer here in Rapid City. You find a man out wide right. Ball comes in. And Washington handling that so far. Goal kick. Jace Hayes been limping around there for quite a while. Finally decides to take himself out of the game. I don't know, it looked like maybe he rolled it. All right, here we go. Courtesy throw back to Washington. Greg with a big punt up past halfway. And now the Warriors attacking into the corner. And that's out for a goal kick. Alamasi having a try there. Nobody to connect with going forward, though. Jacob Nunez carrying the ball sideways, puts it through. Yeah, man, up to six. But just couldn't quite get connected. Zitlau carrying forward. He puts one through. That's banged back out by the Raiders. Zitlau gets it back. Austin Miller with the ball. And he gets it knocked away there. He stays with the play. But will foul coming out. ball bang long there to Blake Burnt. It ends up going out. And we'll see a couple sets of fresh legs come on the field here. A little bit too much weight on that. Nice ball in, first time. Up, up, and away by Tanner Zitlau, but he was offside anyway. I want to take this time to thank those folks on the scrolling dashboard above and below your video player. Play It Again Sports, Sioux Falls. Home Federal Bank, Beef O'Brady's, Original Pancake House, then Cellular Only, with offices in Pier, Watertown, and Sioux Falls. Thank you, folks, for supporting the Sports 605 Network. Streaking down the left again. He's disconnected with the ball as he enters into the 18. Stevens throw. Nick Gregg using his range there on that punt. Be Washington throwing it halfway. Little casual there in the back. Turns into a kind of a hassle for Washington, but they are playing their way out, looks like. Ball goes through. But Greg easily ought to take care of that. Hey, we want to do a big shout out to Coach Chris Derry. Could be Chris is watching from Pierre or somewhere around the state. I think he is in Pierre as they have their U13, U14 team tryouts and training for South Dakota United in Pierre this weekend. Welcome on board, Chris. I wish you were here with. No danger there. Both teams have had chances, probably of the ones there. The most dangerous have been some of the stuff that Blake Burns created up top for Stevens. But both teams showing that they can get in the other sites defending third, and that's what it's all about, getting in there and getting a good opportunity. And that runs out, but it is going to be a corner. Scoreless with 10 left here in the first half. And that kicked out. Also want to wish a big wish to Jesse Payne Usher, all the way out in Reno, Nevada. Turned 13 years old today. Happy birthday, Jesse Payne Usher. Nice save there by Nick Gregg. There was some pace on that shot as it came in. Garcia. And Tanner Zitlau made up a lot of ground there. Not quite enough to get the pass, but throw in will be in favor of Washington here. They're looking for Jace Hafes, cruising down the right there, just a tad ahead of him. Hafes touches it back out. Inside it goes. Hafes has it again. He's keeping the ball. Tried to maneuver through a couple Warriors, but couldn't do it. Now Miller centers. Can't connect there. That's knocked back into the Warriors defending third. Nice piece of work there by the Stevens Raiders. So with just under 7 minutes, the Raiders take a 1-0 lead. That was Jacob Hall on the goal for the Raiders. Junior. They were really wanting that one to go through. They had Jace Hafes again over on the right, and he had a lot of grass in front of him. Austin Miller now with the ball. Pulls inside. Sends one in. And that's handled easily. Hayes with a nice little flick on there. And he gets it back. And a nice turn. Just didn't have quite the angle. Opportunity there, but not enough to get a good touch on it. Three and a half now left here in the first. Here comes Jacob Nunez. He's cut off there. He turns back in. Two and a half now left here in the first half. Miller passes back. They get it over on the right wing. And Jacob Nunez with the ball. Try to combine up through there, but Washington end up with it. Ball out to Austin Miller. He sends a long one in. That's headed back out. Nice switch ball all the way across. Over to Walter Gattaca. Haven't heard any cheers or anything indicating a score from the Rapid City Central Sioux Falls Lincoln game. Okay, Lincoln, I guess, is up 1-0 during the first half there. Steve is trying to use some more of that speed down the left side. And it's kicked out. It'll be a throw-in. Yeah. I see Tyler Lauder, the new coach at Sturgis, has shown up here at the game. Maybe we can get a halftime interview with him. And maybe not. We're down to the last 10 seconds. And that'll do it for the first half. Rapid City Stevens Raiders 1, Sioux Falls Washington Warriors 0. You want to get Tyler? You want to interview Tyler?
Sure.
Okay, well, move your deal and we'll just swing this around and I'll just hand.
All right. This
way. Well, we are going to be able to interview
Carol here with you. We'll just take this little lavalier. All right, right. Well, Coach Tyler Lauder, you're here watching your old alumni and your little brother play, but you're also coaching at Sturgis, right?
Yes, correct.
So tell me a little bit about what's going on over in Sturgis.
Well, in Sturgis, we got a really young program. Okay. They just got brought up from A to AA. Way young. We got two seniors. Everything's all underclassmen.
Wow. Future looks bright then, right?
Way bright, yeah. We got about, I'm going to say about 18 kids that are freshmen and under.
Oh, wow.
So big underclassmen group. So,
outstanding.
Yeah.
Well, and you kind of cut your teeth both playing and coaching here with Stevens, right?
Yep. I played, graduated 09, and then I worked with the last Stevens team to make it to the state championship 2 years ago.
Okay, mm-hmm. And now you're here watching your little brother play?
Yeah, watching him. He's a senior this year, so come out, show support for the Black Hills and everything.
Yeah,
so,
that's great. So
scouting.
Now, have you guys had any games yet for the boys?
We had our first game tonight against Stowe Gorman.
Okay.
Very first game. So.
And how'd that go?
Physically, they're all way bigger than us. They dominated the game physically, but my boys are way conditioned. They've been running like crazy every day.
Okay.
They didn't get tired at all, but just outmatched physically.
Yeah.
So,
but learned some lessons though, right?
Yes.
So now, who do you have coaching with you over there?
Over there, I have Kurt Wilson, who is an alum from class of 2010. Last time Sturgis had a state championship, he was their captain there for them. He's my JV coach.
All right, good. Who are some of the returning players that you have that are going to be you're relying on heavily for some leadership on the team?
Big leadership. I got a big captain up top. His name's Andy. He's big leader and vocal and everything, you know.
Right.
He pushes everybody. And then my other captain is a sophomore. His name's Grayson Nelson and everything. Actually plays down with the Black Hills Rapids and everything. And he's just a leader on the ball and everything.
Right.
So,
you know, one of the things we were concerned about for Sturgis High School this year was the fact that for the rally, they used your fields in the park. So what happened? Are you guys able to play on those fields? Have they been destroyed?
So what happened to us, the huge disadvantage, we couldn't have a tryout week during the week of the rally because the fields are taken. So we were a week behind. Now we're playing on the high school football field, which is only 100 yards long, and it's only 55 yards wide.
Okay.
So it's very narrow, very small, and it's just a huge – and we've been practicing at a backup football field, so we've been everywhere.
Yeah. So is that going to be an issue for – obviously you have to deal with that this year, but what is the thought for next year?
Thought for next year actually might be a positive. They might be building a new stadium where the football field is. So if so, we'll get to use that as our practice field and everything. So we'll get more familiar with it and everything. But
yeah, you got to have a field that's the same size as everybody else's, though, somewhere along the line, right?
Oh, yeah. Eventually, that's the plan next year is to expand everything, make it bigger. So we can actually, when we come down to other places, same size, and we can train on that same size.
Yeah.
So
well, that'll be great. Well, congratulations on your new job there as head coach, Tyler, and wish you the best of luck with your young team, but we're looking forward to the future years.
Yes, me too. It's a bright future for Sturgis High School. Like I said, a lot of young kids, a lot of young leadership, and they're going to be pushing here in the next 2 years. So.
Yeah, well, we're sure you will be. Thanks for taking some time with us here at Soccer 605, and good luck.
Thank you.
Thanks. All right, that wraps up our interview with Tyler, Coach Tyler Lauder, but we also, I just see we have a former player from Stevens over here, and I'm hoping I can get Derek Beaumont to come over and have a visit with us.
Yeah, he's got a good analysis.
All right. Hey, Derek, how you doing?
Good,
I got to get
you?
A hug in, man. Good to see you.
You too. It's been a while.
It has been a while, but you know, thanks to Facebook, I've been seeing a lot of your, oops, I think we just lost our live feed. Hang on a minute. Oh, maybe the audio is still working. Been seeing some of your daredevil acts that you've been working on here.
Yeah, it's about now that we aren't playing anymore, we have a lot more free time to go out
high lining, making rope swings, rock climbing, all kinds of fun stuff. Yeah,
yeah, you've been blowing my mind with some of the daredevil things you've been doing. So tell me, you've been watching the game.
Yeah.
What's your analysis here? We got a 1-0 game.
You know, I knew quite a few Washington kids last year playing through like S United and stuff, and obviously I knew all the Stevens guys, and we lost a lot of people, both teams did, and it's pretty interesting to see how like the teams come together to put together a new varsity squad, and Stevens, they're taking control most of this game, and I think they're going to get the win.
They're going to come out with it?
I do.
Yeah, you know, we didn't even do usually we do a preseason ranking and, you know, take the top eight or so, but this year there are so many changes going on, rosters all across the state. We didn't even do that this year.
No, it's crazy. All the teams from Lincoln to Roosevelt, like I saw there's like some crazy, I was looking at the scores and stuff, and there's some wild games that I would have never guessed the results.
Yeah, and well, and the A and the double A, so it's going to be an interesting season. Yeah. Are you missing it pretty bad?
I'm missing the games, scoring goals and the anxiety before and stuff, but the practice is not so much, honestly. It's kind of nice.
You're not missing practice?
More free time and not be so busy with soccer all the time.
Well, obviously, you're filling your time with a lot of fun activities.
Yeah, we're staying busy.
So tell us a little bit about some of the things that you've been doing again with all that. I know that you've been doing some, I came up in the hills, some rock climbing. Tell us what you've been doing.
Well, a couple years ago, my friend Nehemiah Larimer started some rock climbing. And so we got pretty into that. But eventually, like, you just kind of, like, it's not bored of it, but, like, you kind of want to push limits.
You push the envelope.
Yeah, so we were slacklining, and we saw a picture on Instagram of a slack line at like a couple hundred feet in the air in between rocks. So we had a guy, a professional highliner, come out and he taught us the ropes, kind of showed us how to do it. And we're setting up lines now, 200 feet. Made a trip down to Moab, set up a highline 400 feet off the ground.
Country, isn't it?
Yeah, it's different. It's crazy.
It's like Mars.
Yeah, it's sweet. It's huge cliffs, gaps. Awesome.
So I didn't know that's where you had done that. I saw some pictures.
Yeah, and so we're pretty much just every day just trying to set up new line, do something new.
Just living life to the fullest.
Yeah, just having a good time.
Staying on the edge?
Yeah, no schedule. Just, it's good.
We're glad to see you having a lot of fun. They're going to love running into you tonight. Be sure and give your family our best regards, all right?
Okay, will do. Thanks for having me.
Derek, also an Elite 11 player from last year, was involved in the 96 South Dakota boys ODP team for years. All the little kids are doing a little bit of cheerleading down there. And we want to thank Coach Tyler Lauder and for coming and having a little bit of a visit with us. And you know, you're an old coach when all the guys you coach when their kids are out coaching varsity. And, of course, Derek Beaumont, who really was one of the smartest soccer players you'll ever see anywhere. And he's out enjoying a year of adventure before heading off to Colorado School of Mines next year to become an engineer. All right, well, center Tony Harrison's getting them lined up out there. Second half is underway. Long ball up. They had Blake Bent there, but just couldn't get quite the right touch on it. Goal kick, Washington. Neither team playing very tidy soccer right now. Touched out to Stonehall, he can't quite get to it. Alamasi in the middle now for the Warriors. And offside called. Munn has a try there. Handled very easily by Greg. Zitlau trying to connect with anybody up top. Just a lot of white shirts behind the ball now for the Raiders. Nunez pass intercepted. Hey, Big Sussies, says referee Tony Harrison. And we're going to bring the trainer out. Jay Safe's up. And under his own power. And it looks like Matthew Brambley will be replacing Jay Safe's at left wing. Warriors trying to possess their way out of this. That pass intercepted there by Mum. Dangerous moment there. Jacob Hall almost gets his second goal. But Nick Gregg alertly picks that one up. And another yellow, this time to Mubarak Kadir, as he leaves the field. A little more cheering from the other field. We'll try to get some news for you from that game. Nunez laid it across. Couldn't get anybody with good contact on it over there. Just over half an hour left here in the contest. Raiders up 1-0 on the first half goal by Jacob Hall. Opportunity there, but a giveaway. And Nicholas Schmidt with the ball now for the Raiders. High punt. Raiders looking for Bent down the left. Hall threads one through. A lot of pressure up there by Jake Matkins. For the Raiders. Bent coming hard down the side. But Kyle LeBon able to deal with that. Big tall guy. LeBon. Hard one on the floor. Great idea. Bent did take a swipe at it, but didn't get a good piece of it. Raiders doing a nice job here at cutting those angles off.
Come on, Raiders!
Raiders with 7 behind the ball right there. Jake Matkins with the ball over on the right side for the Raiders. He gets through that, puts it inside the 6, and Nick Grigg picks it up. Nobody there to tap it in. Great ball in. That was Brambley. Had good height, perfect weight on it. Just didn't have a guy there to get his head on it. That one makes it through. And Nick Gregg makes a great save. Bent tries a rebound off that Jacob Hall shot. Great save there by Nick Gregg. Just 24 left here in the game. Warriors are going to have to get to work to make themselves another chance or two. Raiders have done just a great job possessing around them. And the Warriors have not been nearly as connected as they need to be. Goal! By number 11, Mum. Great first time hit on that ball that came out there in the middle of the funnel. Just a classic goal. Thank you. Well, when things go right, things go right. Paul with his second goal of the night. Looked like a little bit of miscommunication, miscue back in the Washington defense there. Not to take anything away from Hall's hustle. Three to nothing now. Stevens Raiders. All again, he wants that hat trick, and why not? Just got a report that on the other field, Rapid City Central and Sioux Falls Lincoln are knotted up and level at two. Somewhere around the middle of the second half over there. That one comes in real high. Brambley with the ball. He's run off it though, and Nick Grigg, Washington keeper, picks that up. Raiders coming forward without fear at this point in the game. Whoa, there's that hat trick from Jacob Hall. He got a nice chunk of space there in the middle and scores his third goal. Nice work tonight by Jacob Hall. Goal kick. Bit much there, says the center, Tony Harrison. Yeah, subs are made. Off we go again. 17 and a half minutes left in the game now. Nice attempt on a cross here by Hall. It's intercepted on its way. That ball can't make it through the defense, but it will be a Washington throw. And that was a nice piece of work, but all for naught because it was offside. Anything that'll make the crowd go ah, we're in favor of that. Hall plays it back to Devin Hansen. Well, finally, Washington gets enough connected passes to get one in. Sure, that was Alamasi. That ball taken away from Bent there in the middle and given right back. Warriors play it back and organize. Long pass up to Bent. He lays it off. Hall can't find his way through. He plays it back. Just ticked under 14 minutes here. Referee Tony Harrison. Settling things down there.
Yeah.
Warriors coming up, and they got a bunch of numbers. That cross just tipped out of the way there by Devin Hansen. Kicked out there. Just over 10 left here. 4-1. Raiders is up on the Warriors. One runs out. And Raider keeper Nicholas Schmidt will put it in play. Want to make sure and remind you folks watching in Sioux Falls to go to the Danielle O'Han benefit at the Gateway Lounge tomorrow, starting at 2 o'clock. Ball tackled away there. And getting a little chippy out there. For the final segment of the game here. And that'll be a Warrior corner with 8.5 left in the game. Want to make sure and check Soccer 605 on the schedules and results pages. We've had a lot of scores and a lot of action coming in from all over the state tonight. I'm sure Carol will have those updated for you. Another nice tackle there in the middle of the park. Yeah, both teams now with quite a few subs on the field. 7 minutes. We will be back tomorrow at 11 a.m. with the Lincoln girls who got spanked tonight by Rapid City Central against Stevens, who have to be very happy. The Stevens girls winning late in the game, 1-0 over Washington. And then at 1 o'clock, this Stevens Raiders boys team will be taking on the Lincoln Patriots, who are in a battle over on the field next to us with Rapid City Central. And entry ball banged out of there. And offsides called. Bennett Fierro giving him some fits up there. His shot goes wide to the right. That pass can't make it through. Nunez lays it down there for Hansen. And we'll see a substitution here for Stevens Raiders. Clock just ticked under three. Blake Bent back on the field now for the Raiders.
How you doing?
Good, Mike. How you doing? That ball touched out of the way there by Tyler Pollocky. Just saying hi here to my old buddy Mike Watson.
Some 605 filming.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool.
We're live. Live stream. Yeah. Yeah. A lot of fun. That one way above the mark. Looks like Lincoln may have just scored to pull ahead of Rapid City Central 3-2. We'll verify that. Most schools are red and white, so the red team scored. I think though Lincoln is wearing the red shirts tonight. Ball centered. Nick Gregg gets in there and gets a hold of it. Under a minute now. That's right. Lincoln does score with 3:20 left in the game to take a 3-2 lead. And that's going to do it here at the Sioux Park Stadium field, where the Rapid City Stevens Raiders put on a fine performance behind a hat trick by Jacob Hall, winning 4-1 over the Washington Warriors. Folks, want to thank you for hanging out here with Soccer 605 tonight. We'll see you back on the channel tomorrow at 11 o'clock a.m. for Stevens Raiders girls against the Lincoln Patriots girls. Have a great night, folks, and we'll see you tomorrow. Thanks again to all our sponsors on the Sports 605 Network.